In this video, I'll show you how to create a drawing once you have your part modeled. So go up to File, make a drawing from the part, and this menu will pop up. What you want to do in this case, in our class, I want you to have you always put your drawings on a B-size landscape unless I tell you otherwise. Please don't use larger sheet sizes because it just makes it too hard to read the dimensions. So B-size, ANSI landscape, say OK. This is the view palette. And this will show you your different views that are available to you. Now, don't put too much weight on what these names are, because it just happens, those just describe the planes. In this case, you're always looking for the view that will be best for your front view. Remember, most information, fewest hidden lines, longest dimension. So this view right here is the one. So click on that, drag it out here, and we're going to put the front view of kind of in the left-hand corner. Come up, click it for the right side, come over, I'm sorry, top, over and click it for the right, and over and click it for the ISO. Just get it in the ballpark. You can arrange it once you've settled. And click on that, and I'm going to hit Escape for a second. So you can just see that box around there. If you click on that and hold it down, you can move this over. And it, likewise with these boxes, whenever you move your cursor over and you can see the box, if you hold down the left button, you can move stuff around. Now, notice how these views are tied to this front view. If you remember back in the beginning of drawings, we said you try to have the same amount of view between the front, same amount of space between the front and the top and the front and the right. So do something similar to that. One thing we don't have is our hidden lines are not shown. We need to show hidden lines in all the view, all the ortho views, not on the ISO view. So if you come over here, you'll see your display style. The second icon here will put the hidden lines on. So now you can see the hidden lines are shown. Let's see, is there anything else? If you want to change the scale, you can come over here and change the scale. Right? Actually, the other scale is just fine. Now, a couple things happened here when I put the hidden lines. I got the hidden line on there. Just right click on that, come over here, and turn off the hidden lines on that view. That doesn't affect. This view is kind of independent of these. Okay, right click on that, we can change the scale, so you're not stuck with, you know, whatever happens to go onto the screen. I like that 1-to-1 scale better. Okay, so that looks pretty good. We need to have space for dimensions. Let's close that out. Let's add our center. Now you have center mark on that, but we need center lines on you. So you always show center lines on the holes. Remember, the center line will show how, if you're thinking about drilling this hole, the way that the tool would go to create that hole. Same thing here. So come up here where it says center line. Now you can either manually put them on there. So if you click on the left hidden line and the right hidden line, it'll put a center line on there. So those are good. But let me show you what else you can do. Let's undo that. If you go to centerline, you can also click on this thing that says auto insert, put a check mark in there, and then if you just click the view, it'll also put the center line. So if you have one that's kind of tricky to get on, that's a really handy tool. Don't put center lines or center marks on your ISO. ISO is just kind of a presentation to show the person looking at this drawing what the part looks like a little more in a three-dimensional manner. Okay, to add dimensions, you're going to go to Smart Dimension, and remember to use good dimensioning practice. Okay, so now, see how that dimension's going up and down? That's not how we like our dimensions to be presented. That's an ISO dimension. We want all our dimensions to be ANSI or ASME dimensions. Go up here to this gear, go Options, Document Property. Now, again, it says ANSI, but it's not. You have to cycle through. I don't know why you have to do that, but you will have to do it sometimes. And it depends on how your software was loaded. And now it's updated, it's fine. So if you're lucky, you won't have to do it. But if you do, if yours isn't working right, fix that. We want always to have ANSI, American National Standard Institute, or ASME, which is American Society of Mechanical Engineer style, not the ISO dimensions. Okay, I'm going to continue with my dimensions. I'll make sure all the features are dimensioned at least one time. In this case, what you want to do is try to line these up. Now you can zoom in and see. If you get close, it'll kind of lock on there, right? So you don't want these weird little staggers. Right? So if you have the opportunity to line up your dimensions, it makes a much better looking drawing. And keep going here. And same thing there. Zoom in on that. Let's try to line those up if we can. There we go. And I do need the depth of this part, so I'm either going to put it on that top view or the right side view, and then I need to locate the hole here, so I can click on there, use those center marks. Remember, use good dimensioning practices. And lastly, we want the diameter of this. So if you just click on the circle, smart dimension, as the name implies, it's pretty smart. If not, you can force the dimension by clicking on this little arrow, and you can tell it what kind of a dimension that you want. It, usually you don't have to do that. And I think we have everything on there. And I know there's no dimensions on this right side view, but it just worked out that way. And then you want to fill out the title block. So use this note tool. And what we're going to put in the title block is you're going to put your name. And you're going to put, oops, MET 132, and then put whatever page number. And your problem number. Make those all caps. Now notice what's in this box is however you saved when you created your part, however you saved your part is going to show up in there. So we'll talk about that some later, but don't worry about that too much for right now. But make sure you identify what this is, page number, problem number, or the title of the drawing if there is no page number or problem number. So that's how you create a drawing, and if you want to just save it then. Now it is creating a separate file. Let me just do a save as so you can see that. In this case, it's going to create a DRW, a drawing file, separate from our part file. If you want to give it a different name, here's your opportunity to give it a different name. Otherwise, just say save, and again, I'm putting it in that same folder with my other drawings. Now to create a PDF, we're going to go File, Save As, and excuse me, select Adobe Portable Document Format, and that's going to take that drawing and it's going to turn it into a PDF file. And that's how I want you to send me all of your drawings. Do not send me drawing files. You must send me PDFs. So again, you just do a File, Save As, and choose a file type as a PDF file. So that's how you create a drawing.